continuous work. We are not perfect, but we're moving to perfection. We release ourselves to you, that Lord, don't stop the work until you are through and until we become what you want us to be.
Amen.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. God bless you, can have your seat. Many of you were here last night. It doesn't matter what the devil is doing, the work is progressing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I just want to pick from where mommy stopped yesterday. A lot of things that I should so I'm sure I will not be able to finish because we just have this morning and the evening. But we can't finish all that we have to minister on the issue of wisdom. It's a very big topic, elaborate. But as an aspect God wants us to hammer on at this period. That's what I'm concentrating on. And so there was a scripture that she mentioned yesterday in person, and she didn't get back on it. So I want to pick from there. Luke chapter 21, verse 34. Luke chapter 21, verse 34. Understand the fact that we're talking about how to walk in wisdom. And also through that, doing mighty works for God. And we've been able to establish the fact that sensitivity to the Spirit is very important for that mighty works. Since it is God that is doing the works, and our connection to Him is what makes us what we are supposed to do part time, He tells us. We go ahead to do it, and then when we do it, in comparison with what other people are doing, they see it as, wow, what a great thing. But it's just because we were sensitive enough to know that that's what God wanted us to do at that time. And whenever you do such, to the understanding of men, it will be something out of ordinary. You are the one that knows that I'm not super compared to you. But I have just been sensitive to Him to be able to know that He told me to preach and I did it. And you think He makes me a superman. I'm not a superman, but I'm working with a super God. Praise God. So now when I relate with Him properly and then He lead me on and I do something that is beyond the normal natural ability of anybody of my age or of my status, then you want to ask yourself, how did that man get that thing? You know, there are times that the Bible says that Jesus Christ will do something and they say, oh, we've never seen it in this fashion before. So it's not that they have not seen miracles. Moses has done miracles. Elijah has done miracles. Most people in the Old Testament too have done some wonderful things. But what was Jesus doing that was wow to them? It was not in the way those people used to do it that He was doing it. There's still something more to His own relationship with God and the way He brings it to the level of everybody. Praise God. And then if we can't operate at the level of Moses, Elijah, and all that because they go to mountaintop, they stay, you know, people like Elijah would just be on the mountain, he won't come out, except he wants to come and talk with people. And the man in the New Testament that operated at that level was John the Baptist. He too was wearing you know, animal clothes and then eating locusts, just staying in the bush. Once they were, they come to town, they go back. But Jesus lived among men. He will eat with them. He will drink with them. They even said he's a glutton that he eats too much. Everywhere he just get to, he eats in the house of Matthew, he might eat in the house of Mary and Martha. Just eating around. This guy is not willing. Praise God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So, they always say a lot of things about him. And there was a time that they were comparing him with John. And they said, you see, God is the one who is operating in wisdom. And this wisdom of God, he has different children. Among the children are the ones that are playing and they expect you to come and dance. Some are also weeping and expect you to come and cry. At least we choose one that you like among the children. Either you like the one crying or you like the one who, you know, singing and laughing. He said, when John came, he was not eating. You people said, he's too holy. How can he be just a man in the bush like that? I came, I started eating people. You said, I'm gluttonous. Which one? I mean, God is the one that brought that person. If God is the one that brought me into. So if you can't take that one, you will take this one. But everything, you're always complaining. Praise God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So I believe that there are different people that God has raised up for different things, and they have different purposes and assignments. Mine is towards you for what God wants to use you for in your generation. Praise God. So you have to cooperate with God and with me to be able to get all that God wants us to have. So I have so much that I pile up. If I'm able to go through this one and finish it, wrap up the things that dulls our spirit. That's very important to concentrate this one. What do I call it? The things that dull our spirit. And I said we're going to start from Luke 21:34. No, let's go to Hebrew, where that word comes from. Hebrews 5. So she mentioned a little about it yesterday, but she was flowing in different areas. So she now did not come back to this point, you know, and move to the other. So I felt my spirit was lashing on that way, still go back to that. Hebrews 5, from verse 12 or 11, of whom we have many things to say and hard to be uttered, seeing you are dull of hearing. Together. Are you reading it in your Bible? So, we have many things to say, they are hard to be uttered, seeing you are dull of hearing. For when for the time you ought to be teachers, you have need that one teach you again, which be the first principles of the oracles of God, and have become such as have need of milk and not of strong meat. For everyone that uses milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongs to them that are full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. But back to verse 11. Can you give me verse 11, another translation? It says, of whom we have many things to say and hard to be uttered, saying you are dull of hearing. I want you to underline dull of hearing. See, dull of hearing is talking of slow in perception, not picking the things of the spirit as quickly as we should, as sharply as we should, because some things have come back your heart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And mommy talked about that a little yesterday, but not much. So me, I still feel I should concentrate on that before, probably in the evening, I will not pick on the areas that God can lead us, or the way we should, through the word, catch the wisdom of God. Hallelujah. That's the real thing that I wanted to minister since Thursday. But I need to clear some rubbish off the ground before I can bring that one. You don't just sow the seed on a heart that is not ready for it. So when he says that, of whom we have many things to say, but have to be uttered, since you are dull of hearing, I want you to see different things there. We have things to say. That means the Spirit of God may have many things he wants to teach you, train you, build you on, so you can become what he's planning for you to become. You can make it easy for him. You can make it difficult for him to do. Praise God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? The way you make it easy is to make yourself available. The little line by line, precept upon precept that you are hearing, you are applying. So you are walking in the level of light that you have. You may not have all the light. In fact, nobody can have all the light that you need to have per time. We keep knowing God. We keep learning about Him. We are knowing Him more and more. He is the perfect one. We are walking and moving to perfection. Praise God. Are you getting what I'm saying? And the more we are close to Him, the more we allow Him to walk His word into our life, the more we can adequately represent Him well, and then we will be like Him. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? So, He said, we have many things to say. So, in the syllabus of God for you, there are courses you should take and pass, and then move to another course, set of courses, pass, move to some other set of courses, pass, and keep moving on until you get to the level that you are not babes, you are sons. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you getting what I'm saying? Because again, if you go to Galatians, we are going to get that even if you are a son, you are qualified for inheritance of a father. But the inheritance that is yours legally may not be handed over to you until you leave this childish behavior, babyish behavior. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Are you getting what I'm saying? Of whom we have many things to say and a heart to be uttered. Since you are dull of hearing,